Today, we are going to focus on MLX Editor, a small application integrated in the Monolix suite. It is a simple text editor that can be used to write a structural model. In Monolix, it can be opened in the tab Structural Model. In a new project, before loading any model, it can be opened by clicking on New Model, and it can be used to write a model from scratch or paste a model copied from somewhere else. If a model has already been loaded, for example here a TMDD model from the library, it can be opened in the MLX editor by clicking on Open in Editor. It is then easy to modify the model, for example to add an output. Here the receptor R in addition to the ligand L. Then save the model under a new name and load it again in Monolix. Of course, you can use any text editor to write a structural model, but this one has some useful features to help the model writing. First, it has specific syntax highlighting for MLXtran, the language used to write model for Monolix. As we can see here, the names of the section output, equation, pk are colored in pink. The name of the macro depot is colored in purple. Keywords are colored in brown, and comments are colored in gray. It makes the writing and reading of the model easier. To know more about the syntax of MLXtran and the different sections to describe a model, you can have a look at the extensive online documentation on mlxtran.lixof.com. Second, in addition to classical features of text editors such as undo, zoom, or find and replace, there is a button compile project that checks the validity of the model and returns an informative message in case of an error. So if I have a typo in some variable, for instance here I have written KO instead of KON, then by clicking on Compile Project I get this error. KO is seen as an unknown variable. In addition, I have the line number where the issue is and an extract of the line. I get the same error if I have added a parameter in the structural model, for example an absorption rate KA, but I forgot to add it as an input to be estimated. Let's see a final example of frequent error. In case of a syntax mistake, for example if I forgot to close a parenthesis at line 32, there is a parse error at line 33, the line after the one with the mistake. Again, the line is also displayed. Once the modified model is validated, I can close the editor. In addition to reloading the updated version by clicking here if I have saved the modified model under the same name, I can also click here to browse the modified model if I have saved it under a new name. It is also possible to use the MLX editor outside of Monolix, as it is also available as a separate application of the Monolix suite. For more information, have a look at our online documentation.